solving a problem where we had mass m connected to a spring and damper element, which in turn are connected to a rigid ball. And we have displaced this mass by initial displacement u0. And when the mass is displaced towards right by displacement u0, the observation commences. That means at time t equal to 0, the mass has been taken towards right by amount u0. And later on, the mass is released from that position. At that position, u0 dot, that is the velocity of the mass at the time t equal to 0 when observation commenced, was 0. And then the mass is released, and then we are observing the motion of the mass, or we are observing the position of the mass as a function of time for three kinds of systems. One is overdamped system, then critically damped system, and third one is underdamped system. As of now, we have not yet defined what do we mean by these words. We will do so in due course of time, but we have defined them mathematically. In this sense, we know the equation of motion of the system, that is mu double dot plus cu dot plus ku equal to 0, where u dot is the velocity of the mass at given instant of time t, u is the position of the mass at given instant of time t, and u double dot is the acceleration of the mass at given instant time t. And initial conditions are u at time t equal to 0 is u0, and u dot at time t equal to 0 is u0 dot. So this is the governing equation, and these are the boundary conditions. We know that by now that u equal to e raised to st is going to be the solution. U dot is s e raised to st, u double dot is s square e raised to st. You substitute all these values in the parent equation, and you get ms square plus cs plus k must be equal to 0. And we get two roots for s, that is minus c plus or minus square root of c square minus 4mk by 2m. If we simplify, it turns out to be minus c by 2m plus or minus square root of 1 by 4 c by m square minus k by m. Are you with me till this point? Type your response in chat box so that I will understand, and then I will proceed. So are you with me till this point? Type your response in chat box. So Vedang says yes. So is only Vedang attentive? What about others? Neil says yes. Okay. So therefore, these are the two roots. And then we had three cases mathematically. One is 1 by 4 c by m bracket square is greater than k by m. That gives real and distinct roots. We call this system as overdamped, and we have already solved for free vibration of the system when it is overdamped. Then critically damped, when S1 and S2 are same, that means under square root sign you should get 0. That means 4 1 by 4 C by M square is equal to K by M. That indicates S1 and S2 is plus or S1 and S2 are minus C is equal to minus C by 2M. And the third case now we are dealing with is the underdamped system, where 1 by 4 C by M bracket square is less than K by M. Are you with me? Please type your response in chat box. This is the third case that we are going to solve for today. We have already obtained the solution for overdamped system and critically damped system. Now, let me know if you have understood this part. Today, we are going to deal with a case where 1 by 4 C by M square is less than K by M. Okay, Rajarshi says yes. So let us solve for an underdamped system. So I'm going to have S1 or S2. These are the two roots of S in this solution. So what are the two roots of S? Minus C by 2M plus or minus square root of C square upon 4M square minus K by M. But C square upon 4M square is less than K by M by definition of underdamped system. By definition. And then we are going to have S1 or S2. See, I can take K minus K by M common. So I can write this as K by M minus C square upon 4m square. Ye minus sign maine common le liya, and square root of that. So I can change this everything in the square root sign in this way. Now c square upon 4m square is less than k by m. That means k by m is greater than c square upon 4m square. So we are going to have this number as positive. But there is a negative sign sitting here, so minus 1 sitting here. But what is square root of minus 1? Square root of minus 1 by definition is I. Do you agree with me? It is a complex number. Square root of minus 1 by definition is I. Please let me know if you are aware of the algebra of complex numbers. Please type in your in the chat box. Are you aware that square root of minus 1 is I? Once I get your response, I can proceed. So please respond. Okay. So now square root of minus 1 is, if I replace it by I, so what do I get? So I get S1 or S2 is minus C by 2M plus or minus, that I will sit outside because square root of minus 1 is taken out. That is I, square root of K by M minus C square by 4M square. Now this C by 2M, I can call it as A for simplification. And this square root of K by M minus C square upon 4M square, I'm going to call it as B. These are some numbers. C upon 2M is one number and square root of K by M minus C square upon 4M square is some another number. So I'm going to treat this root as A plus or minus IB. I hope you have understood till this point. Now, how do we write down the general solution? So we have two roots of S. We write down general solution as C1, that is constant 1, e raised to S1t. S1 is the first root of S, plus C2 e raised to S2t, where S2 is the second root of S. So if e raised to st is the solution, if e raised to S1t and e raised to S2t are independently the solutions, their summation, their linear addition is also going to be a solution. So therefore C1 e raised to S1t plus C2 e raised to S2t is also a solution. This is the same process that we have been referring to for past two cases as well. Now let me write down the solution. So I will replace S1 now by A plus IB and S2 by A minus IB. So what is that I get? C1 e raised to A plus IBT, C2 e raised to A minus IBT. Now you are aware, I'm very sure that you are aware of the rules of indices. Are you? For example, if I have e raised to X1 into e raised to X2. So can anyone unmute and tell me how do I write this? E raised to something. What should be that something? Someone please unmute and let me know. These are rules of indices. Acha, Vedang batao.
Sir, e raised to x1 plus x2.
Great. So we know that e raised to x1 plus x2 can be decomposed as e raised to x1 into e raised to x2. Happy? So therefore, now, if I have C1 e raised to A plus IB times T, I can decompose it into C1 into bracket e raised to AT plus e raised to IBT. Do you agree with me, Vedang? I have dropped intermediate step, but if you want, I will write that step as well. So there is an intermediate step here. I'm not much focusing on mathematics, so I take a liberty of dropping the steps, but let me write down. It will be C1 e raised to A into AT into A raised, e raised to IBT. This is the first term, plus C2 e raised to AT into e raised to minus IBT. This is the second term. I can take e raised to AT common. So therefore, that's what I have done. I have taken e raised to AT common into bracket. What remains is C1 e raised to IBT plus C2 e raised to minus IBT. Are you convinced till now? Are you with me till now? Please type your response in chat box. Then I will proceed. Okay. So now it's quite easy. There is nothing great in it, but you may have lost the touch of this complex this mathematics, therefore I am just elaborating. Now e raised to AT common into bracket C1. Now I am sure that you are aware that I can write e raised to I theta as cos theta plus I sine theta. Are you aware of that? Please type your response in chat box. E raised to I theta in fact can be proven to be equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. Let me know if you know this. then I will proceed. Vedant says yes. What about others? Chalo, respond karo. Without response, I can't go ahead. Yes, Sham says yes. Okay, fine. So therefore, e raised to i bt, I will replace it by c1 cos bt plus I sin bt. Similarly, c2 will be there. It will be cos minus bt, but cos minus bt is cos bt itself. And plus I sin minus bt, but minus sin minus bt is minus sin bt. So therefore, it is cos bt minus I sin bt. I hope you are clear till this point. Wherever you have not understood a step, however silly it may be, please ask. I am there to explain it 1,000 times, but nothing should go ununderstood. So now this is e raised to at into bracket. Now you have a cos bt here. You also have a cos bt here. So I will take cos bt common from these two terms. So I will get c1 plus c2. Then you have a sin bt here. And you have a sin bt here as well. So, and you also have a I here. And you have a I here. So what I'm going to do is I sin bt common. So you will get c1 minus c2 times I into sin bt. Now you have to understand that this solution has to be real. You are plucking the mass towards right and you are leaving it and you are writing the expression for u of t, that is position of that mass as a function of time. It cannot be imaginary. Position cannot be imaginary. Do you agree with me? Chalo bolo chat box mein. Do you agree with me that the position at any instant of time cannot be imaginary? It has to be some real number. Do you agree with me? Please type your response in chat box so that I can proceed. Vedang says yes. Neil says yes. Yes. So therefore, C1 and C2, these two constants must be in such a fashion that their addition must turn out to be a real number. So when is it possible? That is possible only, and their subtraction multiplied by I also must turn out to be a real number. This is possible only and only when C1 and C2 are complex conjugates. How? Because let us say C1 is A plus IB and C2 is A minus IB. So when I add these numbers, I get A plus B, which is a real number. And when I subtract this number, I get A plus IB minus A minus IB. So it is minus 2 times IB. But when that I gets multiplied with this I, it becomes I square, it becomes minus 1, and minus sign into minus 1, it becomes a real number. Do you agree with me? I will just demonstrate. Let us say C1 is equal to A plus IB. Don't confuse it with the A that we have used. So let us call it as A1 plus IB1. And if I say C2 is A1 minus IB1. So when you add these two numbers, this IB1 and IB1, they will get cancelled out. So you are going to get 2A1. So 2A1 will become C3. When you subtract these two numbers, C1 minus C2, A1 will cancel out. This minus IB will become plus IB. So IB1 plus IB1 will become 2IB1. 2IB1 multiplied by I. So it will become 2I square B1. But I square is minus 1. So it will become minus 2B1. So therefore, C4 and C3 both will be real. Are you able to understand what I am trying to say? Please type your response in chat box. I am waiting. Type your response in chat box, then I proceed. Okay, so we understand that C3 and C4, they must be complex conjugate. C1 and C2, they must be complex conjugates so that C3 and C4 turn out to be real and U of T will turn out to be real. But I am least worried about what C1 and C2 really are, because finally I will have to find out only C3 and C4. Once I obtain the value of C3 and C4 in known terms, I am done. That's what we are going to do. So see how I have written u of t. U of t is written as e raised to at into bracket c3 cos bt plus c4 sin bt. And now this C3 and C4, how will we obtain this C3 and C4? Can you type your response in chat box? How do we obtain C3 and C4 in terms of known quantities? Type your response in chat box. I am waiting. Please respond. If you are not able to answer, please say so in the chat box. Find C1 and C2 first. So Vedang, C1 and C2 is not required to be found out because we have called C1 plus C2 as C3 and C1 minus C2 times I as C4. So now only our interest is finding out C3 and C4. That's all. This is the solution. U of t is equal to e raised to at C3 cos bt plus C4 cos bt. And what is the value of a and b? A and b are known in terms of known quantities. So the only unknown here and only unknowns here are C3 and C4. So how do I obtain this C3 and C4? The answer is there very next in the very next step. I have written that step as well. Yes, by take somebody said, Vedant said, by taking eight conditions. So we call them as initial conditions. So apply initial conditions and you will get the value of C3 and C4. How many initial conditions do we have? We have two initial conditions. U of 0 is U0 and U dot of 0 is U0 dot. So these two are known quantities. These two conditions we are going to exhaust to get the values of C3 and C4. So let us quickly finish that exercise. This is all mathematics. And now we are quite acquainted with this mathematics because we have done that for overdamped and critically damped system. So do it quickly. So u at t equal to 0, u equal to u0. So if I substitute t equal to 0 in expression for u of t, what am I going to get? E raised to a into 0, that is e raised to 0. E raised to 0 will become 1. Then cos of b into 0, that is cos of 0. Cos of 0 will become 1. So you only c3 will remain. And sin b into 0, so sin bt will become 0. So this term is going to vanish. And therefore, we are going to have C3 is equal to U0. Do you agree with me? Please type your response in chat box. Vedant says yes. What about others? Okay, great. So C3 turns out to be U0. And now at time t equal to 0, before I go ahead, I will again instruct all of you. Agar chota sa bhi doubt ho, usi vakt pujo. There is no need to hesitate. I am there to clarify the doubts. So please ask whenever you have a doubt. Now, at t equal to 0, u dot, that is velocity, is u0 dot. This is given. U0 dot is known. So first of all, I will have to find out equation of velocity. So how do I do that? U dot of t, I will have to differentiate this equation. So when I differentiate, I see there are two functions, multiplication of two functions of time. So I'm going to apply chain rule. So what is chain rule? First take derivative of first function. So let me take derivative of e raised to at. So what is the derivative of e raised to at? A e raised to at. And keep the other function as it is. So c3 cos bt plus c4 sin bt will remain as it is. Plus, now keep the first function as it is, e raised to at, and take the derivative of the second function. What is derivative of second function? So it is minus c3b sin bt. Are you with me? Chain rule mein chain rule laga rahe hum. Plus c4 sin bt. What is the derivative of sin bt? It is b cos bt. So it is going to be c4b cos bt. Are you with me till this point? Have you understood the expression for u dot of t? Please let me know. Vedang says yes. What about others? Satyam says yes. What about others? Atharva, I have hardly received any response from you till this point. Have you understood? Okay. So soon you are going to have a surprise test. I have spoiled the surprise by saying so, but soon you are going to have a surprise test. Please be attentive in the class. So u dot of t is equal to a e raised to at c3 cos bt plus c4 sin bt plus whatever it is. Now u dot of 0, I have to substitute t equal to 0 in this expression. So when I substitute t equal to 0 here, e raised to a into 0 becomes 1, e raised to 0 is 1. So outside only a is going to remain. What remains inside? In this bracket, when I substitute t equal to 0, the second term vanishes. The first term becomes c3. Now let us look at this term. Plus e raised to at, t is 0. Therefore this term e raised to at becomes 1. And minus c3 b sin bt, this term vanishes. Because sin 0 is 0. And c4b is what remains. Do you agree with me? Please type your response in chat box. हम थोड़ा सा स्लो चल रहे हैं, वो इंटेंशनली चल रहे हैं, बिकॉज दिस इज द क्रूशियल पार्ट. यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड अंडर डैम्ड, ओवर डैम्ड एंड क्रिटिकली डैम्ड सिस्टम इन डिटेल. ओके, सो u डॉट ऑफ 0 इज a c3 प्लस c4 टाइम्स b. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ c4? सो c4 टर्न्स आउट टू बी, व्हाट इज u डॉट ऑफ 0? सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी सेड u डॉट ऑफ 0 इज u0 डॉट. सो इट इज u0 डॉट minus a times c3. This a times c3 will go on other side and it will become minus, and then divided by b. This is going to be the value of c4. Now in this, let us substitute the value of a and b. So what is the value of a and b? These are the values I have substituted that. So c4 becomes u0 dot minus c u0 upon 2m, because a is minus c by 2m. So if already there is a minus sign sitting here, so this should become plus. Are you with me? Am I right? Vedang, can you unmute and let me know?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So it becomes plus c by 2m into c3 is u0 divided by square root of k by m minus c by 4m square. Very good, very well. Now, so u of t now becomes e raised to, chalo u of t ka expression dekhte, e raised to at. But what is the value of a? Minus c by 2m. So e minus c by 2m times t. This is the term sitting outside. Now let us have a look at the function which is inside. So u of t is e raised to at into bracket c3 cos bt. But what is c3? C3 is u0. And what is b? B is this. So let me substitute that. So u0 cos bt. For the solution not to look clumsy, I have kept b as it is. But we have to understand what is the value of b. B is given as square root of k by m minus c square upon 4m square. So ye ho gaya first term. What is the second term? Plus c4 times sin bt. But what is the value of c4? C4 is u0 dot minus a times c3. U0 dot plus. So I'm going to substitute that value here. So it is going to be u0 dot plus c times u0 upon 2m divided by square root of k by m minus c square upon 4m square sin bt. So it is nothing but a cos bt plus b sin bt. Are you with me? Vedang, can you unmute and let me know if you are understanding?
Yes,
what
sir.
You're trying to do? Yes. So this is the solution for underdamped system, pre-vibration of underdamped system. So if I plug the mass towards right and leave it, if the system is underdamped, it is going to follow this equation for its position as a function of time. So let us now plot it. The symbols do not create interest in us unless we have some numbers and we plot the solution and compare it with the other types of systems, which are overdamped and critically damped system. It is not going to make any sense. So therefore, let us continue with the same example that we were taking. So mass is 10 kg. You know, now by this time, you know what example we were solving. K is equal to 1000 Newton per meter. U0, we have two values. Initially, we pluck it by 50 mm, leave it. Then we pluck it by 100 mm towards right and leave it. Are you with me? Are all of you with me? Please type your response in chat box. Yahan tak samajh mein aa raha hai? We are solving the same problem. Please let me know. I will look at chat box and then I will go ahead. Yes. So let us go ahead now. Now I have to choose C. How do I choose C such that the system is underdamped system? So you know, critically damped system, we have the value of C as C star as 200. So this value needs to be less than that. Just a minute.
Sorry.
So for overdamped system, we have taken the value of C as 300. Now let us take the value of C less than 200, and therefore I have taken it as 50. You could have as well taken it as 100, 150, whatever. As long as it is less than 200, it's okay. We will prove this in the other way. Chalo, when do we say that the system is underdamped? System is underdamped when this relationship is followed. This is how by definition we said. Do you agree with me? So let me bring in that definition here. So can you quickly tell me now what is 1 by 4 C by M bracket square? So I will calculate that value. C is 50. Chala dekho yahan pe C 50 hai. What is the value of M? M is 10. So 50 by 10 is 5. 5 square is 25. 25 by 4 is 6.25. So therefore, I have this value as 6.25. And what is the value of K by M? K by M is 100. 1000 by 10, 100. So is C square upon 4M square less than K by M? Yes. So therefore, the system is underdamped. Are you with me? Vedant, can you unmute and let me know if you have understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. So we are quite sure there are two ways of looking at underdamped system, knowing whether the system is underdamped. One, have a look at the value of C star, that is critical damping. If your damping is less than critical damping, system is underdamped. Or second way of looking at it is C square upon 4M square. Calculate that. If it is less than K by M, your system is underdamped. It's just like finding out, there are various ways of finding out whether the section is under reinforced section or not in RCC. Whenever the position of neutral axis is less than, or whenever the neutral axis is above the neutral axis corresponding to balanced section, we say that section is under reinforced. Whenever AST provided is less than AST for balanced section, we say that it is balanced section, under reinforced section. So there are various ways by which we can know whether the section is under reinforced or not. On similar lines, there are various ways by which we will be able to know whether the system is under damped or not. Are you with me, Vedant?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. I'm asking Vedant, but I'm taking you as a representative of class. Agar kisi ko kuch doubt hai beech mein, to aap kabhi bhi mujhe rok sakte ho aur pooch sakte ho. I don't have a habit of working with the class which is not so interactive. That's why I'm asking this. Please improve the interaction. Now, A is equal to, so let us try solving this problem. So, C upon 2M. What is the value of C upon 2M here? So, C is 50. Mass is 10. So, 2 into 10 is 20. So, 50 upon 20 is 2.5. So, C by M ki value kitni aa gayi? 2.5. Then what is the value of K by M? We have already found out it is 100. Value of 1 by 4 times C by M bracket square turns out to be 6.25. Now we are going to find out. See, in the solution, we have this B here. So we need to find out the value of B. So what is the value of B? Value of B is nothing but square root of K by M minus C square upon 4M square. But what is K by M? 100. What is 1 upon 4 C by M bracket square? 6.25. So what is square root of that? 100 minus 6.25 ka square root. That turns out to be 9.68. So we have got the value of B. Now the job remains is to, what the job, the only job remains is to substitute these values in this expression. So that's what I'm going to do. U of T. What is C by 2M? So I have calculated C by 2M as 2.5 here. So therefore, the first term is going to be e raised to minus 2.5 t bracket. U0 remains as it is. Cos of bt, b we have calculated as 9.68. So cos of 9.68 t plus. What is u0 dot? U0 dot is going to be 0. Do you agree with me? Vedant, do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, so sir. In this problem, U0 dot is 0. And what is the value of plus c by 2m? C by 2m is 2.5. So it is going to be plus 2.5 u0. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Divided by, चलो divided by क्या है देखो solution में, this is nothing but b. So what is the value of b? B is 9.68. We have calculated the value of b somewhere, isn't it? B is calculated as 9.68. So divided by 9.68. Happy? Multiplied by sin bt. So what is the value of sin bt here? Sin 9.68 times t. Chalo, Vedang, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So we have simply done the substitution. And now comes the part of plotting. So let me share my, let me stop sharing this screen. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So we are now dealing with underdamped system where we have taken the value of C as 50. Happy? Vedang, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So u0 is 50 and then u0 is 100. We have two cases. So u0 is equal to 50. In that case, how should I write the expression? So just have a look at expression written here. I hope you are able to read the expression. Are you, Vedang?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So exponential minus 2.5 times. Exponential minus 2.5 times t. But what is t here? T is nothing but a4. Do you agree with me? Let me hide just 1 minute. Let me hide these columns so that you will be able to relate. So we are dealing with now underdamped system. T is a4. So just have a look at expression here. Exponential minus 2.5 times a4. Happy? Vedang?
Yes, sir.
Till this expression is over, please keep yourself unmuted. Then yes, as we, as I go ahead, this a4 will go on becoming a5, a6, a7, a8 like that. So it is t in fact. Then in bracket, what is the expression u0? So first case is u0 is 0.05. So you can see the value 0.05 here. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That is 50 mm. 50 mm by 1000, that is 0.05 meter. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Multiplied by cos of 9.68, cos of 9.68 times a4, a4 is t. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Then I have made an error here. Here it should be plus. So I am changing that. Plus 2.5 u0, 2.5 into u0 is 0.05 divided by 9.68. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Multiplied by sine of 9.68 times t. T is nothing but a4. So that expression I have shown here. Now look at this graph. What is the difference? So pehle zara ye bhi kar lete. Let us plot on the same graph. If I pull the system by 100 mm towards right, what am I going to get? So in the same expression, what I need to do is, I just need to replace 0.05 by 0.1. Dekho 0.1 se replace kiya, yaha pe bhi 0.1 se replace kiya. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So in this very same system, let me add now this graph. So kya hamara notation tha? Colors humne kuch finalize kiye the na?
Yes, sir.
So let me unhide this graphs. To kya colors finalize kiye the? Dekho. Dotted one was, dotted red line was for second case. So that's what I'm going to stick to. So add, select data, add series. I'm going to add the series where the first column is going to be time. So let me use that. just 1 minute. And the second series is going to be this one. This I will call it as series 2. Done. So let us have, and let me make this one, this line. Are, why am I not able to select series 2? Great. Just give me a second. Okay, here somehow right now I'm finally I could select format data series, and I'm going to make it dotted one. Format data series line style 1.7. Okay, so this red dotted line shows you the response of the underdamped system when it is moved towards right by 100 m. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now remember, सबसे पहले हमने जब exercise किया था, when we were considering the undamped system, let me show you what we expected, what kind of response we expected. So let me show you that. So this is the lecture one. Are you with me? In lecture one, I said that this is the response that we will expect. The system from U0, that means in this case, either 50 mm or 100 mm, it will start moving down. It will reach to a point where it is less than U0. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And then this amplitude will go on diminishing, and finally it will come close to zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
This is what we expected. And this is what we are getting now. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
It starts from 0.1 and then goes only up to minus 0.05 maximum. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Then come back. The amplitude goes on diminishing, and finally it approaches zero. Happy?
Yes.
So jo expect kiya tha response, wo to mila hume. Lekin kab mila? When we are considering when we are considering a problem of initial disturbance given to a system which is underdamped. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Not overdamped, not critically damped, or not undamped. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Undamped agar system hai, to response kaise milta hai? Batao. This is the response for an undamped system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
It will keep on vibrating forever. If the system is critically damped, what is the response that we get? This is the response that we get. It never crosses the mean position. Happy?
Yes, sir.
When it is overdamped, we get a similar response to critically damped system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है. क्या डिफरेंस है वो हम देखने वाले हैं. But essentially the similar response as critically damped system, where the mass never crosses the mean position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But when there is an underdamped system, mass crosses the mean position, but the amplitude of vibration goes on decaying with time exponentially, and ultimately it reaches to a mean position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
so these are the three differences between these are the differences between three types of systems. कौन कौन से है? Overdamped, critically damped, underdamped and undamped. Four systems देखे हमने अभी तक. तो उसमें
yes,
सबसे practical system कौन सा है? Underdamped. Most of the cases, you can observe, you can just hit the table top and leave it. You will hear that humming noise. That means it is vibrating about the mean position. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And finally, it will come to the rest. That is the one observation. Another observation. See, whenever your vehicle passes over a hump, then you will experience up and down movement. Do you agree with me? That vibration
yes, sir.
Is quickly brought to zero. That's all right. But essentially, you go beyond the mean position. When a vehicle yes, or a train passes over a bridge, the bridge after the passage of train experiences vibrations on either side of mean positions. So typically, all the systems, if you look at a building which is subjected to earthquake ground motion, after the earthquake phenomena is over, it vibrates in such a fashion that it goes on both sides of mean positions before coming to rest. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So 99% cases, the systems that you would find in this world are underdamped system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
They will exhibit the free vibration response as shown in this diagram. Happy?
Yes, sir.
अब हम एक छोटा सा एक्सरसाइज करने वाले. क्या एक्सरसाइज है मैं बताता हूँ आपको. We will do that exercise in a while. But before that, I am going to bring your attention to a fact that देखो हमने जहां से शुरू किया इसमें the roots S1 and S2 were complex. Do you agree with me? They were not real.
Yes, sir.
But the solution of U of T is real. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So underdamped system ke liye merely because S1 and S2, which are the roots of this differential equation, they are complex. It doesn't mean that the solution U of T has to be complex. Are you with me?
Right, sir.
So this is the tricky part. Mathematics and physics, in dono ke beech mein aapko samajhna hai ki which is acceptable and which is not. Agar mera solution hi complex number aata, I would have discarded that solution because there is no thing as complex position. Can you say,
yes, sir.
I traveled today by 10 plus 20 kilometers. What is this nonsense? Ye ho nahi sakta. Are you with me?
Right.
So therefore, as the solution has turned out to be real, I don't pay attention to S1 and S2 being complex. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So underdamped system, the first point to note is, when you propose e raised to st as a solution, its roots s means two values of s that satisfy the differential equation s1 and s2, they are inherently complex in nature, but the solution is not. U of t is not. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Second thing that I want you to bring your attention to is this. Because that solution s1 had a complex number in it, therefore, only this oscillating solution was possible. Kyunki e raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. Cos theta and sin theta are oscillating functions about mean. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Right.
So the very fact that the solution of S was imaginary, not imaginary, complex. Therefore, we had a solution which was oscillating about the mean position. Happy?
Yes.
I am bringing your attention now to only mathematical facts, but which correlate with the physical observation very much. So, ye facts dekhne zaruri hai. Ab zara mujhe batao, ye jo cos bt aur sin bt yahan pe aapko terms dikh rahe hain. So, you will understand that cos bt will fluctuate between minus 1 to 1. Do you agree with me?
Right. Yes, sir.
Sin bt also will fluctuate between minus 1 to 1.
Yes, sir.
Cos bt cannot exceed minus 1 or plus 1 magnitude wise.
Yes.
Sin bt yes. also cannot exceed minus 1 and plus 1. What happens to the function cos bt plus sin bt? Wo dekhne ki koshish karte. This is now digress. Are you with me?
Yes.
देखो कोई भी सॉल्यूशन आपको मिल जाता है तो एक वे ये है कि सॉल्यूशन मिल गया हुर्रे लेट अस लीव इट. ऐसे नहीं चलेगा. वी हैव टू लुक एट इट फ्रॉम ऑल पॉसिबल एस्पेक्ट्स. ऑफ कोर्स आई मे आल्सो बी मिसिंग सम ऑफ द एस्पेक्ट्स, बट यू हैव टू कीप योर क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग अलाइव. सॉल्यूशन के तरफ एक ही नजरिए से नहीं देखना है. वी हैव टू लुक एट इट फ्रॉम ऑल द डायरेक्शंस सो दैट वी गेट द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ फिजिकल फेनोमेना. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
जहां तक मैं देख पाया हूं वहां तक मैं आपको लेके जाऊंगा, उसके आगे आप क्रिटिकली थिंक कर सकते हो. सो नाउ लेट अस हैव अ लुक एट, लेट अस टेक अ डाइग्रेस. डाइग्रेस का मतलब होता है विषयांतर. सो लेट अस टेक अ डाइग्रेस एंड लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द फंक्शन साइन बी टी प्लस कॉस बी टी. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड फॉर द डिस्कशन पर्पस लेट अस टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ बी एज 9.68 जो यहां पे मिली थी हमें. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
So this is 9.68, and I am going to now plot that function on the Excel. Excel is going to always come to your rescue for many of the times. So now, but instead of using the first sheet, now I am going to use the second sheet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I will copy these things in the second sheet, and I will delete everything else. ये सब delete कर देंगे. Let us keep only t, time t seconds. And what is this function now? I am going to now type the function sin bt plus cos bt. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So sin bt plus cos bt, where b value is 9.68. Happy?
Yes.
So sin of 9.68 times t, t means a4. Happy? Plus cos of 9.68 into t. तो यहां पे देखो, if I click this point, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
If I click this point, I get it as 9.68 times A5 plus 9.68 times A5. Are you with me? A5. So if I click the next cell, it is A6 and A6. So I am taking the corresponding time. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Let me plot this function. How does this function look? It again looks like a periodic function. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
But now its values are bound by, we can just have approximate look here. We can say that they are bounded by plus or minus 1.5. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So, ab zara yahan pe dhyan do. This function is bounded by the values plus or minus 1.5. Happy? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, ab iske saath jod dete hai ye U0. Happy? Vedang?
Yes, sir.
तो U0 किसके साथ जोड़ना है? Cos के साथ. So U0 की अपनी वैल्यू कितनी थी? तो पहले तो 0.05 लेते हैं. So I am now looking at a function. And what is the value of this? 2.5 into U0. So I am doing this as 2.5 into U0. That is 0.05 divided by 9.68. Can you tell me this value, Vedang? Tell me how much is that? बोलो
सर. 0.0129
मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस फंक्शन. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू प्लॉट दिस फंक्शन. सो व्हाट इज दिस फंक्शन? दिस फंक्शन इज एसेंशियली दिस पार्ट ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
अच्छा, सो 0.0129, देखो 0.0129 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय sin of 9.68 into t, and then you have 0.05 multiplied by cos of this. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
If I change that, what happens to the solution? Solution is still periodic. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
And it now fluctuates between the values plus or minus 0.05. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So, ये जो प्लस 1.5 था वो अब हो गया प्लस और माइनस 0.5 के बीच में चालू होना, आर यू विद मी?
यस सर।
फ्लक्चुएट होना चालू हुआ। अब जरा मुझे बताओ, जस्ट लेट मी नो, आई विल जस्ट गो बैक टू द प्रीवियस शीट। प्लस और माइनस 0.5 में फ्लक्चुएट होने वाला सॉल्यूशन कौन सा था? देखो इसमें भी तो एक ब्लू लाइन वाला सॉल्यूशन है दैट फ्लक्चुएट्स बिटवीन 0.05 एंड 0.0 माइनस 0.05। डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर।
तो इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि सॉल्यूशन का जो ये पार्ट है, इफ आई लुक एट ओनली दिस पार्ट ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन व्हिच इज इनसाइड द ब्रैकेट, इट इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम एज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ फ्री वाइब्रेशन ऑफ अनडैम्प्ड सिस्टम। डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर।
जिसमें कोई डैम्पिंग ही नहीं था, ऐसे वाले सिस्टम का जो सॉल्यूशन है वो ये पार्ट है। डू यू एग्री विद मी?
राइट सर।
आई एम नॉट सेइंग अंडर डैम्प्ड, आई एम सेइंग अनडैम्प्ड। आर यू विद मी?
यस।
तो अनडैम्प्ड सिस्टम जैसा ये सॉल्यूशन है जो दिख रहा है मुझे, वो हैप्पी, ये जो फंक्शन मैंने प्लॉट किया, आर यू विद मी?
यस सर।
इसका मतलब है इफ आई वेयर टू कंसिडर ओनली द सॉल्यूशन इन द ब्रैकेट, दैट सॉल्यूशन विल गो ऑन फॉरएवर, द सिस्टम विल कीप ऑन वाइब्रेटिंग अबाउट द मीन पोजीशन फॉरएवर। डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर।
द ओनस ऑफ डैम्पिंग द वाइब्रेशंस इज ऑन दिस टर्म। डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर।
हाँ, तो अब जरा देखते हैं कि अगर मैंने सिर्फ e रेस टू माइनस 2.5 टी ये फंक्शन प्लॉट किया तो वो कैसे दिखता है। Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am going to plot now that function here. So कौन सा function है? Exponential or e raised to minus 2.5 t. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Vedang, just before we do this exercise, क्विकली लेट मी नो इन चैट बॉक्स, आपको ये जो एक्सेल प्लॉटिंग में दिखा था वो आपको यूजफुल लगता है या आपको कंफ्यूजन होता है? प्लीज टाइप योर रिस्पॉन्स। इफ यूजफुल लगता है तो यस बोलो, कंफ्यूजन होता है तो कंफ्यूजन लिखो। Okay, so if it is useful, I will continue with this style. Otherwise, I was thinking of changing the style. But as you find it useful, let us do it this way. So e raised to 2 minus 2.5 t. ये अब plot करने की कोशिश करते हैं. So how do we plot that? This is equal to exponential minus 2.5 times t. अरे, 1 minute. 2.5 multiplied by and let us have a look at how do we have this function as. So on the same graph, now I am going to plot format data series. Oh no, not format data series, select data, add data series. In this, now I am going to add this function. So let us do that. You will understand what point I am trying to make once we plot this. Oh, okay, it would have been better if we would have plotted it separately. So that's what I will do. I will plot it separately. Yeah. So look at how this function looks like. This function, we call it as enveloping function. Why? Because each ordinate of this function is going to get multiplied by this. And therefore, the effect that you are going to see is diminishing function. Are you with me, Vedan?
Yes, sir.
So, देखो इसकी maximum value 1 है and then it exponentially approaches 0. as time progresses. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So, जब मैं मल्टीप्लाई करता हूँ तो स्टार्टिंग में तो ओरिजिनल फंक्शन पे कुछ इफेक्ट नहीं होगा, लेकिन जैसे जैसे आगे बढ़ूंगा उस फंक्शन की वैल्यू 1 से कम है, सो देयरफॉर द मल्टीप्लिकेशन विल ब्रिंग डाउन द वैल्यू ऑफ एवरी वैल्यू इन कॉलम बी. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
सो लेट अस नाउ हैव ए मल्टीप्लिकेशन. सो देखो एक ही रिस्पॉन्स है जो यहाँ पे मिला है, मैंने उसको एनालाइज करने की कोशिश की. कैसे एनालाइज किया? First we looked at only e raised to minus 2.5, then we looked at only bracket. If you look at only bracket, that is exactly the same response as undamped system and it will keep on oscillating forever. But e raised to minus 2.5 t is the function which has the onus of bringing this response down to zero as t progresses. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us take the multiplication. So how does the multiplication look like? This multiplied by this. So initially there is no diminishing. You have a look at this. Then systematically the response goes on diminishing because this factor goes down. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let me plot it. So it looks like what we have obtained here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So ये solution देख के ये imagine कर पाना मुश्किल है कि इसमें दो functions एक दूसरे के ऊपर हावी हो रहे हैं. एक function है which is oscillating forever and there is another function which is called as enveloping function which brings down the magnitude of oscillation systematically. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
तो अब मुझे बताओ, if I am interested in knowing in how much time the system will come to the rest, what is the governing factor out of these two? Tell me. Vedang, have you understood the question?
Yes, sir.
If I ask you, if I plug the mass by 100 mm towards right or 50 mm towards right, in how much time will the system return or will the system almost stop vibrating? Kitne time mein ye hoga? ये क्वेश्चन अगर मुझे आंसर करना है तो ये जो ब्रैकेट में फंक्शन दिख रहा है उसके तरफ देख के कोई फायदा नहीं, क्योंकि इट इज ऑसिलेटिंग फॉरएवर. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
सो द रेट ऑफ डीके और द रेट एट व्हिच ऑसिलेशंस आर डैम्पन विल बी गवर्नड बाय दिस टर्म. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड देयर कम्स द पावर ऑफ डैम्पिंग इन पिक्चर. सो हाउ दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. In next class, we are going to change the values of this damping and you will see how the system, how the time required for system to come to the rest changes from changes with various values of damping. How sensitive it is to damping, that you will see in the next class. Are you with me?
Yes. Yes, sir.
So with this, we are going to stop here. So in next class, once we are done with all responses of all the systems to a initial disturbance, essentially we are talking about free vibration. We have seen three systems: underdamped, overdamped, and critically damped. In the next class, first of all, we are going to look at C as a parameter and its effect on time required for decay of oscillations. That is the first thing that we are going to do. Then we are going to revisit the definitions of critically damped system, overdamped system and underdamped system. Now with more physics involved. Abhi tak mathematically diye the. Ab knowing these responses, knowing this system's response to the initial disturbance, we will clearly specify the definitions of these systems in physical domain. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us stop here today. अगर किसी को कुछ डाउट है तो पूछो, अदरवाइज यू कैन टाइप योर रोल नंबर एंड नेम इन चैट बॉक्स एंड यू कैन लीव द मीटिंग.